Well, I decided to write the book because I was seeing all the issues happening in the world around us, climate change, drought, floods, wildfires, and everything I had learned in my dissertation. And then I gave birth to a tiny little baby. And honestly, I wanted to protect the world for him. I wanted to make sure that the world that he grows up in can sustain him, can have enough food and water and life for him to enjoy and live healthfully. So really my motivation in writing the book was my son and his generation and protecting the earth for him and also the other animals and life that we share this earth with. So my background as an educator is I get to work with the next generation of students and I get to teach them everything that I've learned about climate change, food security, the environment, and what we can do to help this planet be around for the next generation. My role as a dietitian is I get to work with individuals on a daily basis to put practical actions into use to help improve their lives and their healthfulness and also hopefully the planet. And as a researcher, I've had the fortune of being able to travel around the world and learn about different cultures, about the foods they eat, about what they're going through with climate change and food insecurity and the environment at large. And putting all of those things together has really led me, I think, to have a credibility and an ability to work with individuals and groups at large to really teach them what I've learned and that is practical that they can use in their everyday lives to help. My number one tip for what someone can do to help both their own health and well-being, as well as the planet, is to go on a plant-based diet. The reason for that is we know that it can prevent and reverse many chronic diseases such as cancer, diabetes, and heart disease. And as far as the planet, it uses so much fewer resources from land and water, and it produces fewer emissions. So going on a plant-based diet really is the number one doable thing that you can start today to help your own health and the planet. My book has several topics in it, including the way our food contributes to climate change, how dietary guidelines are impacted by the environment and how they impact the environment. It talks about our use of plastic, how we're exploiting the planet, and also how we exploit animals that live on this planet. But my book also talks about a lot of the good that is happening on this planet. So there are groups out there that are protecting wildlife, that are protecting the oceans, and I do acknowledge all of that good because I think it's important to remember that there is good happening. And then my book also covers topics about what can we do as an individual today to really help the planet. So for example, I talk about diet, which is the number one impactful thing that we have a choice of doing today. And then it also talks about our buying habits, whether we make sustainable purchases, how we shop for food, fair trade, sustainable, the clothes that we wear. So I cover myriad topics in this book. Yes, I think as an advocate for the environment and the planet at large, I do think it's always important to model the behaviors that I want to see. So in my own life, we eat a healthy plant-based sustainable diet in my home with my son and my husband. We walk to work. We live close enough. We didn't buy that big house so we could live close to work. We live in a condo. We bike to my son's school. We use community gardens. We shop at farmers markets. We try to limit our use of plastic as much as possible. And so we try to model the behaviors that we wish to see in others around us. My favorite plant-based recipe is actually one that my husband is excellent at making. They are plant-based enchiladas and they're just delicious. They have tofu and black beans and mushrooms and they're just so full of flavor with spices and corn tortillas and tomatillos make the sauce. So that's probably our number one go-to plant-based recipe. Our second one is probably biryani, which is sort of the equivalent of ratatouille, but the Greek version. And they're both very hearty dishes. They keep you full and they just have delicious flavors so you don't ever feel like you're missing out on anything.